Hey everybody, it's Pembroke W, Korgi here. As I've mentioned before, one of my favorite video games ever is BurgerTime. It was a pretty huge game in the 80s, and I still think it holds up pretty good, all things considered. However, I've noticed like a lot of 80s era games, the protagonist, Peter Pepper's character design is pretty inconsistent among a lot of the artwork for this game. And I thought it'd be an amusing video to just take a look at how different these are and how weird some of them are. So let's take a look at them. If you guys like this, I can do this with other characters, because Lord knows there is some weird artwork out there of Pac-Man and Mario, and I'd be more than willing to go over those too if you guys find this interesting. But I wanted to start with Peter Pepper, so let's take a look. Oh, and before I get too far into this, I'm just going to focus on the artwork used for the original BurgerTime and not any of the sequels. I'm not going to look at the artwork for like Peter Pepper's Ice Cream Factory or Super BurgerTime or the Flintstones BurgerTime in Bedrock, because I still can't believe that was a thing. Even though I owned that game at one point, I still can't believe that's a thing that happened. We're just sticking with BurgerTime, the original BurgerTime for this. It will be like arcade art, console art, whatever I found while looking this up. The first one we're going to look at is the original design. This is artwork was originally used for the like Japanese promotion of BurgerTime because it was released in Japan by Data East. And in this, Peter Pepper kind of looks like my dad, or a really weird exaggeration of my dad. My dad's nose is not like that, but he's got my dad's stash and his hair, receding hairline, kind of hair color, long face shape. Yeah, it kind of looks like my dad. It's really weird. He seemingly hates hard-boiled eggs, I guess. Also, why is the egg hard-boiled in this? In the game, it's always a fried egg. That's kind of weird. And he coming onto that like piece of cheese? I mean, it's got like lipstick for some reason and feminine looking, and he's like, come on, baby, get on the burger. What is this?
It's not easy being cheesy.
What is up with that hot dog? He looked weird. And is that a lemon? Why is there a lemon on this? There's no lemons in BurgerTime. Why would you put a lemon on a hamburger anyways? It's really got some egg hate going on because this is like the BurgerTime flyer art. And on the back, it has the hamburger going, no, with throwing off the egg. Dude, I've not had hard-boiled egg on a hamburger before, but I've had fried eggs on a hamburger. And that's actually freaking amazing. That actually is really good. Maybe they're like, no, you gotta get fried, bitch. No, only fried eggs here. The game was made by Data East, but for some reason, it didn't get released originally by Data East in America. It originally got released by Midway, and the artwork Midway used looked more like this, and this is kind of the artwork I think of when I think of BurgerTime, because this is the version of the game that I was used to seeing as a child. So this is kind of my interpretation of what I imagine, and it's this weird kind of cartoony art. It kind of has a very like old school, like kind of, I don't know, 1940s, 1930s, 1940s kind of cartoon art style to it. It's a little sloppy though, but it's still, it's got a lot of those elements to it. I kind of like it. I don't think it's my favorite artwork now that I've seen multiple interpretations, but it's interesting. I think I like it better than the original Japanese art. A lot of the video game covers that came out are very much based on this kind of artwork, drawn in a variety of different qualities. Like, for example, here's the Texas Instrument computer software version of BurgerTime, and it's fine, except for what the hell is up with that hamburger? It doesn't look like a hamburger. It looks like it's made out of seeds or something. That looks kind of gross. I think they over-detailed it. It also just looks really off-putting, because everything else is very simplistically drawn, and then this hamburger's just got all of these little, like, seeds or whatever on it. It's just really off-putting. Here's a version of the ColecoVision cover art, and again, it uses the Midway art, but it's also kind of weird because, I don't know, Peter Pepper's eyes looks like he's seeing some shit. Like, he is tripping out. The fumes from this hamburger that's being cooked, that he's setting on, is really messing with his head. Not to mention, why is he on top of a hamburger being grilled? It's like he's grilling himself with the hamburger. Guess that's the secret sauce. This is like an advertisement art. This is actually pretty good. It looks more like someone colored a coloring book than an actual promotional art, but I don't know. It looks actually pretty good. I think the art is kind of cheap, and it kind of looks traced, and the coloring is very, very cheaply done, but I don't know. I weirdly like it. Later, though, Data East would gain the American rights to BurgerTime and re-release it themselves in arcade on their Deco cassette system, and they used a different art style from Midway, which is they used this marquee art. What is going on in this picture? Kind of digging Peter Pepper's weird, like, chef hat mask thing going on in this picture. It looks kind of cool. It's kind of a neat style. Congo line of burger parts and hot dogs? I don't know. Last I remember, the only living food characters were like Mr. Hot Dog and Mr. Egg and Mr. Pickle. And I see Mr. Pickle and Mr. Hot Dog here, but I don't remember no Mr. Burger and Mr. Cheese in this game. It's kind of weird. Time for the food train, I guess. I don't know. I kind of like this cover. I may actually like this one more than the Midway art. I also find it weird that some of these covers feel the need to make other pieces of the burger alive for some reason. I like this also little part over here. It's like the animated characters are nasty, but they're also tasty. So why not mix them in your burger? Yeah, why not? Fuck them. Kill them, I guess. They don't deserve to live. They deserve to be dead. This is from the NES game. I like this cover a lot. I don't know if I like Peter Pepper's design in this. He looks like he went to Bozo the Clown's like barber or something, but other than that, I think this is actually a really nice looking cover. I think it does a perfect job of summing up the game in my opinion, because it's like you've got Mr. Hot Dog, Mr. Egg, and Mr. Pickle. You've got all the like different layers and the ladders and pieces of the burger falling down. I think this sums up the game perfectly. I look at this picture and BurgerTime is just like, bam, that's what pops into my head. However, I do want to point out the Famicom artwork for this game. I like this art a lot. It's got a very kind of like old school manga look, like kind of a 60s, 70s era manga look, but it also looks like something that you would see in a diner. Like this looks like some diner promotional art. It's really cool. I really like this art. It's very stylish. There's weirdly other living characters, like there's this tomato guy and some cheese up here. It's like, they're not in the game. Why are they on here? I like this cover a lot. I think this actually looks really cool. I like that the egg is also wearing sunglasses for some reason. Do I like it as much as the Nintendo art? I don't know. I think this is more stylish looking than the Nintendo art, but I don't know. I like the Nintendo art better because I think it better represents the game. Also, there's this LCD BurgerTime game that came out like in the early 80s. I had one of these when I was a kid because I fucking loved BurgerTime. Seemingly, there's like different artwork for this, but this is the artwork I remember because I got the Mattel version. Seemingly, there's a Bandai version, a Tandy version, and a Mattel version. The Tandy version uses the same art as the Bandai version. This is the Mattel art, and I think it's kind of funny because despite the fact it's an LCD game and the art that's used in the LCDs do not look like the art from the actual like BurgerTime arcade machine on the little LCD game, they decided to make that art look like the BurgerTime arcade sprites, and I think it's kind of funny looking. Mr. Hot Dog has these just eyes that are levitating in front of his face. It's just kind of weird and surreal looking. I kind of like it. Bandai cover looks like this. I like the thick outlines and how just stylized it looks. It's very cool. Very simple. This almost looks like something that you get from a like, I don't know, a 90s cartoon in the like Dexter's Laboratory era BurgerTime cartoon or something. Very thick outlines. I like this look. I actually like this a lot. Commodore 64 BurgerTime game. Egads. What is this? This is so ugly looking. Like, Mr. Hot Dog looks like a fucking zombie. Oh my god, and Peter Pepper just looks creepy as shit. Whoa, he's only got like 3 fingers? Oh, this looks uncomfortable levels of terrible. I fucking hate it. I hate this. This looks so gross. I just don't like this at all. Look at all the detail in that fucking lettuce. It's like the amount of detail he did on the burger and the lettuce actually is pretty impressive. Peter looks bad. That hot dog looks bad. Oh, it looks so gross. I don't like it. I don't like this at all. So overall, what is my favorite interpretation of Peter Pepper we saw today? And I would have to say, I think it's the weird hat mask version of him from the Data East American Marquee. I really like that version. I think that version is actually really neat looking. Second, we'll go to that Bandai one. The Bandai one's really cool. I like the droopy mustache. He looks like that stereotypical chef look. I think it looks good. Third goes to the Midway one because that's the one I'm most familiar with. It might be nostalgia talking, but when I think of BurgerTime, that's usually the image that pops in my head. Fourth, we'll go to like the Famicom version of Peter Pepper. I think that's very stylish and cool looking. I like that look for him. It looks good. Fifth, we'll go to my dad because he's my dad. If I don't put him in this list, he might disown me. Love you, Dad. So this is just a little weird overlook of Peter Pepper. Let me know if you'd like to see more of these. I could definitely do one on Pac-Man or Mario in the future for another Unscripted Honesty video. But yeah, Peter Pepper's had some weird designs, and see ya!